Man, dude. Yeah. The music this episode is fucking nuts.
Yeah, man. This shit is fucking off the fucking Richter, man.
So are the drinks.
Yeah, dude. Okay. Fro's having him a plate right now, this motherfucker.
Yeah, man. You know.
That's how we do. Fucking Young Smooth called Rock Y'all out of Charlotte, North Carolina. MySpace.com/makemoneymakemusic. I'm feeling the hell out of that, man. Mr. Porter be doing them beats, too.
Always.
Yeah, Mr. Porter won't call into the fucking show. Detroit. You know what? I didn't get to touch this. Detroit hatred is at a fucking all-time high right now.
I don't think it's hatred. I think it's arrogance.
Arrogance.
Arrogance. Why? Very appropriate.
Jay Dilla died. We're fucking important.
I don't know. I don't know why. It's like, don't get me wrong. Fucking love the city. Fuck, I was born there. But a lot of the artists that's coming out of there, man, it's like they think more of themselves than what they really are. Like,
by the way,
on a national scale.
Shouts to Danny Brown.
Yeah, now that's one dude who ain't an asshole. He's
humble
the anti-asshole.
Yes.
Big shout out to Danny Brown. Dude is, he's plugged in with that whole Detroit underground scene, man. Got a track. Hopefully we might be spinning one of his joints later on during
you
the, you know, some of the, another portion of the live show. But dude is talented. 22, I think he is.
Yeah.
Dude spits fucking, like, he just angry, just raw.
Oh, yeah.
Dude is a beast. But aside from him, a lot of the other Detroit cats can't really, I don't know. I can't co-sign
you, man,
for a lot of these dudes right now.
Even the websites, man. I'm not kidding. I tried to reach out when people started putting out shit for a group called Street Justice.
Yeah.
And they're like, we're trying to get 5,000 downloads.
Yep.
And not to toot our own horn, but I know that we could get fucking downloads for people.
No doubt.
And so we posted it on the fucking blog.
You went out of your way and sent it to who else did you?
You want me to fucking, oh, yeah, we sent it out to Now Right, Two Dope Boys, fucking, we sent it out to like a bunch of fucking blogs.
Trying to circulate it and get them some downloads.
Because the album was tight.
Yeah. Why did we do it?
Just,
no reason.
Just because we're showing love.
Rep the D.
Hell yeah. Fucking circulated it a little bit. Hit up the people who originally posted it.
Mm-hmm.
Fucking acting like the shit ain't ever fucking happened. Their shit went from 50 downloads
to like
2,500 in a fucking 3-day period, and they're trying to hit a $5,000 or 5,000 download thing.
And we're not trying to take responsibility for all of that, but goddamn it, the shit that you spread it to.
Hell
and
yeah.
The people actually posted it and gave it some love, man. That's the fucking, that's a
no
big
response.
Portion of it. Yeah.
We try to push the underground shit, but when motherfuckers are not even going to fucking hit us back, not even say anything, be a bunch of fucking assholes, it's the websites, it's a lot of artists, fucking Royce, fucking Guilty Simpson.
It's another one I want to get at, too, but due to a situation. Obi just split with Shady Records, which is...
Yeah, man, I wish we could have fucking
made that happen. It's been a nice split. You know, ain't been too much animosity as far as between Obi and M, but he's no longer on the label. He's doing his own thing, so we was trying to get him on here, too.
So yeah, and just so people know, we were trying to get Obi, Joe Budden,
it has been a lot of people.
Who are we trying to get just this show? Fucking all hip hop. We're trying to get like fucking 10 people this show and nobody.
Still disappointed about Budden.
That man, he.
It is what it is, man.
It's going to be ongoing.
I'm going to be mad about it.
But,
I'm going to hate.
So, Detroit, man, I mean, shoot, if y'all could, you know. Get off the bullshit, man. Let's get some fucking unity. And down south, you don't see this shit. New York, there's a whole clique, a whole circle that fucking all show love. They
rock.
Share shit. They all, you know,
rock.
Vibe off one of each other. Yeah, they all rock with each other. Mm-hmm. And it's a beautiful thing. Down south does it. Even out there on the West Coast, man, you got other sites out there that fucking cross-promote shit. But for whatever reason, man, right here in the Mitten, it ain't popping right now.
So, hell no.
Yeah, let's change that shit, definitely. For real, for real. But shifting up gears, though, man, getting back to the, it's another thing
about.
That kind of goes to the age debate. The fucking Neptune shit. They group Nerd.
And were we gonna talk to somebody on the line?
Yeah. We'll wait. You know, wait till they call in. But like you were saying, you said that shit is like, what'd you say? It's like hipster black folks.
Yeah.
That's they rock and roll.
Come on, Nerd.
Yeah. Cause
Neptunes.
Yeah.
Hey, I mean, go ahead.
Man. All right, it's just same. It's the same fucking shit with Eminem.
Mm-hmm.
You have the white dudes who say they fucking hate hip hop but like Eminem.
Which
hate hip hop
makes no sense. Yeah.
They hate hip hop but they like the early Kid Rock shit.
Mm-hmm.
They hate hip hop but they like fucking ICP.
Mm-hmm.
The same thing with fucking hip hop heads with black dudes.
Yeah,
they hate fuck. I mean, I'm sorry, SK dude. I don't mean to. I mean, I'm a fucking huge fan of your blog, but loves the hip hop. Post a fucking rock and roll Nerd. That shit is not hip hop. Because Pharrell did it? Because Pharrell's in it? Uncle Cracker did some fucking hip hop shit.
Yeah.
He ain't posted his shit.
Yeah,
I'm just saying, it's like
all
of
a sudden.
Hell yeah, it hasn't. And I know where Fro's coming from, but I don't agree.
Yeah,
I mean the thing
that,
is,
and the other thing is, you got a lot of people to touch along the how you said some people say they hate rap, but like Eminem, a lot of black people do that. A lot of black folks be like, can't stand fucking rock and roll, but then they'll turn around and rock to that fucking Nerd album.
Yeah,
and it's like, okay, I mean,
yeah,
let's be real, call it what it is. The shit ain't hip hop. At least from what I heard, I haven't heard a lot of this one.
I wonder if those same people will turn around and listen to Jimi Hendrix and Lenny Kravitz.
Possibly. But if you're going to listen to that, then fucking don't hate on rock and roll as a whole.
That's what I'm saying.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
It's like saying, no, go ahead. Yeah. That was going to be
You were saying it was an age thing, though, were you?
I'm saying you getting old as fuck, man. Because
what's age got to do with that?
J-Mac's age has to do with that.
How? Why?
Because anything this dude that does not fall directly into a bucket of what he believes it should be in, he hates it. I don't hate shit. I hate country music. If a motherfucker want to play rock and roll, I don't give a damn.
I don't think he ever said he hated it. I think he said he hates the double standard. I don't think he said that he didn't like the music one way or the other. I just think he said it was there's a double standard.
He hates Soulja Boy.
Yeah. I hate Soulja Boy. No doubt.
I was just checking. Just wanted to give you an opportunity. Hey, man. Enough of that. Let's swap. Who on the line?
Yeah, we got Snoop on the line.
Snoop from where? Blessing?
What's good, man?
What up?
Major.
What's popping, bro? We talking about this generation gap.
J. Mizak.
What up, man?
Yeah. And we talking about
generation gap.
Yeah, that's going on in hip-hop. Yes, sir.
Yeah, how
we're not talking about them young broads.
How you feel about the new Neptunes album?
The Neptunes album? I ain't even heard it yet.
That's that shit you don't even bootleg.
Oh, yeah.
Man, Neptune. When they come out?
It just dropped. And the thing is, man, it's all rock and roll shit for the most part. But what we was talking about is, like, you got a lot of the, and I'm going to say it, it's a lot of younger people that be like, I can't stand rock and roll. I hate that rock shit. But then they'll fuck around and listen to the Neptunes. And it's like, that's a double standard. Just like you got, some redneck folks that say they can't stand hip-hop, but they love Eminem, which don't make no fucking sense. It's like, if you like him, then you like a small portion of hip-hop. Just like if you say you hate rock and roll, but you're going to rock with the Neptunes, then obviously you like a little bit of rock and roll, motherfucker. It's a double standard. And it seems to be more young people that do that than older folks.
I gotta hear this Neptune. They
done
went rock and roll on people.
Hell yeah,
rock and roll.
The majority
really?
Of the album.
You got the CD in there. Can he hear it? You got it on number one.
Let me hear a rock and roll. Oh,
I'm not kidding.
Let me hear one of the tracks.
Major, can you cue it up? I don't know. Don't even know if it'll work, but we'll try it.
I'm trying to cue it up.
Why y'all doing that? But yeah, I hear you. But what's the generation gap though, Major?
No, we're talking about. Right now, the Ice-T and Soulja Boy controversy was big, on the internet, big in the news.
That's like they two generations away from each other.
Yeah,
right, that's a big time generation gap right there.
And then the thing is, you had people choosing sides. You got a lot of other rappers, jumping in saying either they supported Ice-T and they was like,
rappers.
Then
you had Ari Spears.
Everybody has their opinion. Have their opinion. They can have whatever. They can talk about whatever they want. But when it comes to hip hop, I think the generations need to come together. You know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, we all is hip hop. We all represent the same music, regardless if it's rock and roll rap or knowledge rap or gangster rap or snap crackle pop rap. You know what I'm saying? Dance rap.
Fruity Loop.
The same. You know what I'm saying? So to me, Ice-T, I feel him, but at the same, I don't feel him. Because I don't think you don't like it, but I don't think he should try to degrade it.
Or invite it to his dick.
His former hip hop, or they former hip hop.
Yeah, that's where I wound up. In the beginning, I'm like, I feel what Ice-T's saying, but the thing is, man, the more it went on, he came off bitter. You know what I'm saying?
He sounded like a hater.
Yeah, it was pure hate.
See, that's what I'm talking about. Like, there shouldn't be no hatred. I mean, I ain't gonna lie, we all have stuff that we don't like in the game.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. I'm like, shoot, let's be honest.
But we don't all have an album coming out.
Garbage rap. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people didn't think he was hip-hop.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
But we all dug his breakdancing.
Ice-T? Yeah. You didn't think Ice-T? who didn't think Ice-T was hip-hop?
I'm just saying, I mean, people from the East Coast.
Oh, yeah.
At the time,
East Coast people didn't respect no Ice-T.
Oh, hell
no. Are you serious?
You're right.
Yeah. A lot of people always view Ice-T as a lyrical lightweight.
Just like Lil Wayne's album was a fucking... Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, yeah, we can touch on that, too. But no, like, back in the day, a lot of people view Ice-T as a lightweight, lyrically. He wasn't saying
basically.
Shit. You know what I'm saying?
He did a couple of nice things where it was like, you know, like the nigga album, he did Cop Killer.
Yeah, he did some like, revolutionary shit, but he ain't that hot.
Right.
Yeah,
I'm with you. Exactly. That's how I feel.
But you know what? But it was a form of hip-hop, though. You feel me?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And you had to respect it. You definitely had to respect the gangster rap and the pimp rap from Ice-T. You feel me? You brought a whole different aspect to the game.
So explain how nerd falls into fucking hip hop. Just because of producers?
Yeah, they're talking about the Neptune shit. Hold on, I'm going to see if I can cue a song up real quick.
Yeah, like, here, hand me the case real quick, because fucking Sony sent us a bunch of fucking CDs.
Yeah, shit, tell me a track to play, because I don't know none of these titles.
Ice-T used to dance.
Good. Which one?
Soulja Boy dances now. What the fuck is the difference?
I can't remember
the name. There ain't no difference at all.
Just pick anyone, man. I mean, the majority of it's fucking rock and roll.
J-Mac's about to love Soulja Boy tomorrow.
It's probably easy. Look, okay, hold on. Here we go.
That ain't.
There's a few tracks.
That's rock right there? That's
not
rock.
No. That's probably not one of them.
I mean, what's the difference between Soulja Boy?
Can you hear any of this, Snoop?
MC Hammer.
Snoop, can you hear that music?
Hold on a minute. Tilt your
head back and close your eyes. How about now? There's not very many Asians in hip hop. And perhaps this is the Asian part of the Neptunes coming out in the music by, you know, all this, I don't know.
Yeah, well, he can't hear none of it, so, I mean. It's really,
I can imagine what the hell.
Look, there's a fucking red gorilla on the front of the fucking CD.
Fucking little monkey.
Yeah. I don't know.
Yeah, you know, Neptune, they got to do something that's abstract. They got to be different in the game. Right. You know what I'm saying?
They even sometimes
they
have to be
really
a little gay.
A whole different direction. You know what I mean? When it comes to this hip hop.
He said a little bit gay.
I don't expect nothing less.
For real, they do.
You said the whole CD is like that. Wow.
They got to be a little gay. I mean, with them, if that motherfucker wear one more purse.
Yeah. I hope the motherfucker gets
tendonitis. I hope he get tendonitis in his elbow carrying that goddamn purse like that. Yeah, that's some fucking little gay stuff.
I'm waiting for the first homo rapper to come out and
no doubt.
He's out. He's out there. I'm not going in.
Who is it?
Huh?
Name names, motherfucker. Come on, Phro. Who is it?
I'm not going to go there.
He's going to say
but
it's
I know he's out there.
Is it Slickback Ivanhoe?
He's out there.
But I'm telling you right now, one day, it's going to happen.
Oh, yeah. Take the dick in your booty.
and the game is going to support him.
He going to sell. He going to go diamond.
Be real with himself.
He going to go diamond in 3 days.
Yeah, I feel you, man. But, hey. I appreciate the call, and we about to keep going live, man. We're going to get back into this and some other debates later. So if you can, man, hit us back in a minute. I got a track I got to spin for the Smooth Beats listeners because we almost at the 8 o'clock hour. I got to get this joint in real quick. And this is the winner from episode number 6.
Good luck, Snoop.
Good luck, Snoop.
For sure.
All right, man. And we about to jump into this. And then all the people on Smooth Beats, man, after this track is done, come on over to hoodhype.com. And go to the blog, and you can continue listening to us, continue rocking with us, man.
July 12th, we're live.
And they're censoring me. They're censoring me. So wait till we get off this Smooth Beast thing. Come over to Hood Hype. As soon as you come.